I request participant one Inest 144 to start the presentation. And kindly kindly start the webcam.
Good evening, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yeah, you are audible. Just keep your webcam on. Inest 145. I think he's not present. We can move to Inest 146. I request Inest 146 to unmute and start the presentation.
Good evening to everyone present here. Good evening to the jury and my co-presenters, and hope the evening finds you in greatest of health and well-being. So today I'm Shivina Bhatia, first of all, from Chitkara College of Pharmacy, Chitkara University, Punjab, and I'm a third year B.Pharm student. So today the topic for my presentation would be focusing on metabolomics as an accelerator in the herbal drug research process. So first of all, what is omics technology? Omics technology is the high throughput screening and investigation of epigenomes, genomes, proteomes, transcriptomes, and metabolomes in an unbiased manner. So according to the central dogma of life, the information flows from DNA to RNA and to proteins with an increasing level of complexity. So omics technology basically helps to entangle these complexities at all the levels. As you can see in the adjoining figure, figure one. So please, can you move the screen there? So omics technology basically consists of epigenomics, then genomics, then transcriptomics, followed by proteomics and metabolomics, and untangling the various complexity at all the levels and basically studying every aspect of it. So metabolomics is the part of omics technology that refers to the scientific process of identifying and quantifying various metabolites present in the cells, tissues, fluids, and organisms. So metabolites basically provide a function of the cell. Any change in any level of metabolites will clearly indicate the problem with that metabolic process in the body. And if there is any alteration in the subsequent metabolic pathway, therefore giving an insight into the various pathways and processes. The study of metabolites is directly correlated with the molecular phenotype of the biological system. So can you please move to the figure two? So the figure two clearly indicates how is the phenotype of a human body is influenced by various factors, and that further we can analyze all these changes through metabolomics. So phenotype is influenced by the genetic and epigenetic factors, age, environment, or in diseases, pathological conditions present in the individual, drugs, nutrition, and lifestyle. So coming to the main focus area of mine, metabolomics, this has been continuously found to accelerate the process of herbal drug research and forms the prime source of investigation in upcoming phytotherapeutic treatments for the treatment of various disorders. It has helped in identification and quantification of various metabolites present in the plants, and the various techniques involved in metabolomics are gas chromatography, mass spectroscopy, liquid chromatography, mass spectroscopy, and liquid chromatography, solid phase extraction, and nuclear magnetic resonance. So basically, these technologies provide the spectra or the pattern of peaks and the metabolic profile of the part of the plant, and which can be interpreted using various spectral databases that we have, and that classify each metabolite present in the sample and its quantities according to the peaks occurring in the spectra. So some of the databases which are present with us about the spectral data for our reference are mass bank, GOM, metabolome, and lipid or MAPS, and the figure 3 gives us an insight into the role of metabolomics at various processes in the herbal drug research process. So can you please move there? Figure 3, sir, at the bottom. So So metabolomics is involved in the drug discovery, dose evaluation, pharmacology, identification of composition of herbal supplements, enzyme discovery, biochemical pathway discovery, phytochemical isolation, phytotherapy, and generation of metabolic databases, efficacy in animals and humans following the treatment with herbal drugs, and at last clinical safety, toxicological effects of drugs. So concluding my post presentation, metabolomics platform is providing an opportunity for the herbal drug research process, herbal drug discovery, and qualitative control of the medicinal plant and the herbal dosage forms that are formed out of it, and also in predicting the dynamic picture of the complex phenotype of the biosystem through the study of endogenous and exogenous metabolites. So it has been crucial in fostering the overall process of herbal drug research and ensuring the proper investigation, safety, efficacy after the treatment with these drugs. So thank you so much.
Relatives can ask the question.
Thank you. Thank you, Shivina, for your presentation.
Welcome, sir. It was great.
So can you give me a couple of examples for a metabolite which has a significant impact on human health?
So plant metabolites, so plant phytotherapy.
Yeah, you talked about plant metabolites, right?
Yeah, sir, yeah.
Yeah, please, can you give me a couple of examples?
So there is various phytochemicals which are involved in like treatment of multitude of disorders. Like we say for malaria, we have artemisinin, for Taxol, which is extracted from Taxol baccata for cancer. It's quite implemented in cancer. So we basically these things are involved in the isolation and identification of various phytochemicals, metabolites present.
Okay. So you are in third year, right? Third year you have completed or?
Sir, my final exams are going on.
Final exams are
going on. 6 semester, yeah, sir.
Okay. So you have talked about somewhere about various techniques like NMR, mass and solid phase extraction and so on, right?
Yeah, we have some study.
So have you studied anything?
Yes,
gas chromatography, liquid chromatography, and solid phase extraction, all those things you have mentioned. So have you studied anything related to that in your program at your BFAP?
I have studied spectroscopies, chromatographies as a part of herbal drug technology and as a part of other subjects that were previously covered in our semesters.
Okay. So can you differentiate any two aspects between liquid chromatography and gas chromatography?
Yes, sir. Liquid chromatography is basically when we use the neutral gases with the mobile phase for the identification of metabolites, and liquid chromatography will use the liquid.
Liquid as a?
Liquid as a mobile phase.
Okay, what about stationary phases?
Stationary phases will be, I'm sorry, I'm a bit at this moment. I'm not able to okay. Answer that.
It'll be either solid or either liquid. Both are possible, yeah. Right? So yeah. Depending upon that, you will class it into normal phase or reverse phase. Yeah, okay. Thank you. I'm done. Yeah. So others, Ganeshan sir or Patil sir, so you can please take it forward.
Yeah, madam.
Yeah, so is it audible? Yeah, good evening, madam. Really, it was a nice attempt done by you. 3 or 4 years back when IPC was conducted in your place, I had been there to visit your place in and around all the departments. Really, you are having very good, nice infrastructure. And your faculties are showing much interest towards research also. I had been there with your faculties, interacted with them, and some of the students also. Really, you have taken very novel topic and the way you have presented us also very nice. Really, that area I should be appreciated to you, and really very nice presentation. Because metabolomics towards biotechnology aspect, what way it is applies towards herbal drug research. Really, being a third year student, it is very difficult for you to give the thorough input towards us. Level, really, it was a pretty good, nice attempt.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Yes, Shivina, you took a novel topic. Can you just highlight on what are the probable challenges in this metabolomics? Can you highlight few?
Sir, please complete the question. I'm sorry for interrupting.
Yes, this is novel topic. I just want to know you whether you are knowing about what could be the problems, what could be the challenges in metabolomics when you use that for drug discovery or maybe for any other application. Do you know that?
So basically, metabolomics, it's all about the techniques that are being quite used. So according to me, the probable drawbacks of this can be like there can be errors in the identification, or there can be there can be errors in the proper identification, or there can be difficulties in doing that sometimes because of impurities or because of the mixing of samples or so.
And what do you think when we can use for the complex biological system? Whether we can use good.
Whether we can use this for complex biological systems?
Yeah, for complex diseases or maybe where we have a lot of pathways for the disease. Then what will be the problem there when we use this metabolome?
Sir, sorry, what will be the?
What are the things that maybe we get, whether we can go for complex biological systems for treating various diseases which have a multiple pathways, how metabolomics can work on that?
Sir, basically, omics technology can be used in entangling these all the complexity. So these can surely be implemented in complex biological systems for the metabolites. Why I have chosen metabolomics? Because basic metabolites can give us a picture of all of the pathways involved. So we can if there is an alteration level or in the production of any metabolite, so we can interpret whichever might be the doubtful pathways causing this. So we can elucidate from that what can be the possible treatment aspects. So metabolites can basically give us the picture about all the things that can, at the minor molecular level, the picture of what can be wrong in the basic scenario.
Okay, which is the latest article you have referred for this? Which years?
Sir, 2021 and 2020 I have referred.
Can you tell me the journal for that, 2021?
I don't remember. I have referred the journal Medicinal and Aromatic Plants, Academia Press.
Okay. That is from my side. We can move on to the next.